So, we've done Llandudno now. I've just filled up, where are my Knutsford services on the M6. The services that says no trucks allowed, but they've got four big diesel pumps and spaces for trucks to park, so I can figure that one out. And we're on the way to Royal Leamington Spa. If anyone can tell me why it's Royal, please do leave it in the comments section. Wow, how the fuck am I supposed to see what's coming out of this junction? Hope and a prayer. What ridiculous. Why wouldn't you put the giveaway on the other side of there? Leamington Spa for a day off. We're gonna, me and the bus are able to turn up at the gig a day early because they've got nothing on. Well, it's today, I go, technically it's 1:15 in the morning. So we're both gonna park there. The bus will have power, which means that if I need to charge my laptop app or whatever, then I can, you know, use the microwave, kettle, etc. on the bus. And yeah, I expect I'll probably spend a little bit of the day just catching up, editing some video files. And then the rest of the day will probably be spent in the nearest Wetherspoons, if Leamington Spa even has a Wetherspoons. It must have. Even a posh place like Leamington must have a Wetherspoons.
I'm
trying to think what the meal deal is on Monday. Can't remember. Oh well. But yeah, day off, then a gig at the Royal Spa, and then Bournemouth Pavilion. But for now, we'll just have to deal with the M6, which is closed junctions 10 to 8, which I believe is going to affect me, so hopefully it's not too bad of a diversion. Just have to see. The loading dock is there, and I want to get the other side of it on that funny little grey bit. Is the bus here yet? Nope. Beating the bus. Try and get in here without blocking the road for too long, because I think that's the police station, sort of car response place there. I don't really want to be in the way when one of them comes flying out, or in, with a criminal in the back. Do they get criminals in Leamington Spa? I can't imagine so. Seems way too posh of a place for that. Okay. We'll just get in and then we'll have a shuffle. I think what I'll do is do what I did the other night. Get the lift out and we'll see if we can make it flat. It's going to be difficult to judge with those bars in the way. I'm Might even require a little shunt in the morning. I think we're going to be able to do it. Just have to go. I think that door's new. Oh, I don't know. Anyway, let's go back a bit. We'll just have to get out and have a look. I might just bump it up. So if I do accidentally hit something, it's going to be the railing, not the wall. How's that? How's that? One more little nudge. One little nudge. That's good. That can go off. They can go off. They can go off. That can go off because that's going to start annoying me. That's on rest. So I've now started a 45 hour rest at 3:15, and I think what I might do, dump the air out of this so I don't roll out of bed. Alright. What's that? Oh, it's a camera. Close, is it? Oh, that's alright. That back up. Heater on because it's a bit nippy. And job's a good one. Just stopped for some coffee. Well, no, not for coffee, I stopped for hot water. Bit of a tip actually, that pretty much every services I've ever stopped at stupid o'clock in the morning will give you hot water to make yourself a tea or a coffee with if you've got your own.
Second exit, A34.
Because I'm not a massive fan of Costa coffee. Mainly because of the price, but I also don't think it's that great a coffee. And I'd like it like really strong coffee, so I buy ground or beans and ground it up myself, and they're always really, they're fine with it. Take in my little cafetiere, ask for some hot water, as long as you're polite they usually oblige. So we've done that, we've been on the road for about an hour, well just shy of an hour and a half. We've got 3 hours and 6 minutes of driving left. Over. Well, the main road was shut not long after I turned the camera off, and this diversion, I'm stuck in about a convoy of 10 or so trucks. Because these hills, I was down to first gear on a hill a couple of minutes ago. Like, it's just, these really aren't truck roads. I'm in the Arctic in front. I mean, I'm only in an 18 tonner, so I'm sort of criminally underpowered anyway. But you know, Arctic units generally got a fair amount of, you know, horsepower behind them. But the one in front, every hill, he's down to like walking pace. So yeah, not not a fucking great move from the highways agency, really. I think it must be about a 20-mile diversion as well. But it only seems to be this way. The road, I guess, I don't think the road was shut going the other way because I've not seen any traffic coming past the other way. We'll be right back. Guildford again. This is one of the first places where I did a video. Thank you. Right then, boys and girls. As you would have probably seen,
there's the other one,
in the time lapse that we'll have just finished, it's not been the easiest journey up on the M1 tonight. The amount of lane closures, needless lane closures as well, has amazed me. But anyway, the last few gigs have been good. The last few drives apart from tonight have been good. Once I get back to the lockup, which, it won't clip, should be in about half an hour, I'm off for 2 days. Come on, Mr. Man, press the button. This will probably be the last clip. There we go. For the next video, and because I've got 2 days off, I shall edit all of them, and I'll probably have the next one up Sunday, I reckon. Currently at Trowell Services, which is the last one before turn off for our lockup. I'm spending 2 days there, and then the next gig is Southport. So I figured I've got just under a quarter of a tank, so I figured I might as well fill up. It'll make things a bit easier, I won't have to stop. At least it's a quick pump. Filled up the other night somewhere, just out of boredom really. I only put a third of a tank in, and it was like slower than a car pump. It was agony. I have to swap hands, no good. But yes, can't think of much else to report really. It's all been pretty standard, pretty smooth, which is always good. Nothing's really happened on the way up apart from the lane closures that you'll have seen in the time lapse. The button that adjusts the steering wheel height is broken. Luckily it's stayed locked in the last position that I had it in, so that's not an issue. I'm struggling to think of anything else to tell you really. I think once this clicks off, that'll be it until Southport. What are we doing? Southport to Eastbourne. That's going to be a fun drive overnight. Right, now you'd think that'd be it, but if you just do that, probably get about 180 litres in, I reckon. The more I cram in now, the longer it'll be till I have to stop again. Although I will have to stop for AdBlue sometime next week, because it's only got a little tank. $190 maybe? Hey, there we go. Apologies if I've been shaking around, but it is literally just above freezing at the moment. There's all sorts of ice warnings and stuff like that going on. Chuck them in there, that can shut, and I will see you all, if I can open the door, in Southport.